A few weeks ago at work, we launched a project explaining how to vote in every state, and the amazing Taylor, who wrote all 53 scripts for the videos on that channel, shared a story about her personal entry into the world of voters. It's a really great video, link in the description, and it's also a really great idea, and so belatedly, here is mine. Like Taylor, I was also super enthused by the democratic process at a pretty young age. We actually hosted the polling place at our house when I was growing up in California. This is actually a thing that my mom's parents had done before her. She grew up with this, and so she did the same thing with us. Even as a kid, I was pretty aware of Election Day because of how there were voting booths in our entryway. I spent the summer between my junior and senior years of high school at Northwestern attending what was basically government nerd summer camp. And I went off to college in DC, fully intending to major in political science, though the story of why that changed is for another day. When I was in high school, my family moved to Missouri, and so we stopped hosting polling places in our house. And so I did not realize until the morning of my 18th birthday that it was a school board election day. But once I saw that newspaper with its spread of candidate statements, I was so hyped. I read through them all, and I talked to my parents about who they were voting for and why, which in a school board election is mostly like, I know them kind of a deal, but we talked it through, I wanted to get all the information. We had a half day at school that day, I think because of statewide testing, which I didn't have to do as a senior, and so I left at noon and I went over to the polls with my mom, all excited to cast my first ballot, and then I discovered that Missouri is not a same-day registration state. I was eligible to register months earlier because I was going to be 18 on election day, a fact that is the case in most states, probably all states, but I'm not sure about that, so we're just gonna say most states. But I missed it, and I was crushed, which in turn made the poll workers very sad for me, but you know, nothing they could do about it. Still, the day was not lost. My mom cast her ballot, and we left the polling place and drove downtown to the county courthouse so that I could register in person, which truly for me was an A+ way to spend my 18th birthday. I mean, voting would have been a better way to spend my 18th birthday, but registering to vote was like number two. That fall, I headed off to college where I was quickly recruited to volunteer on a statewide race in Maryland. I actually missed out on a lot of like final bonding, saying goodbye time with my mom because I was at this campaign office so much, like immediately, which was kind of a sign of all of the like classmate bonding and like actual class attendance that I was also gonna miss out on because I spent so much time at this campaign office, but that's not the point. The point is that I love campaigning. It is the most politically enfranchised that I have ever felt. I eventually even scored a fancy title. It's still unpaid, but Maryland has a community service requirement for high school graduation, and those clever politicians included political campaign work in the community service requirement. So my job was basically organizing all of the high school volunteers who were a hot minute younger than I was, but it was awesome. And then come election night, I got to sit in a hotel with the rest of our very young staff celebrating not only our victory, but also watching the returns and watching the Democrats retake Congress in 06. I made several little posters that fall that were collages of like bumper stickers for other candidates that we did rallies with and some of our flyers and this news clipping in which I am visible in the photo. And those would be on my walls for the rest of my college career. I, you know, would pack them up and rehang them in each new dorm room. But more important than any of those little posters to my college decor was the envelope containing the very first ballot that I ever cast, my absentee ballot in which I voted in Senator Claire McCaskill, part of that changing of the tide that I got to celebrate on election night. And because my room at my parents' house is still my room, I'm pretty sure that envelope is still hanging up on my wall in Missouri, where it has been since I graduated from college. I really do wish that I had been better informed about the registration process, though, so that I could have cast that very first ballot a little bit earlier that year, which is a big part of why this work project is so very important to me and dear to my heart. So if you haven't seen those videos yet, they will be linked in the description, so please go check them out and find out everything that you need to know to get registered and be ready for election day, and maybe also share them with anybody that you know that might need the extra nudge to get registered and get to the polls. And if you are so inclined, I would love to hear in the comments below about your early experiences with voting. Bye!